afternoon. Good evening.
Good evening, sir.
Okay, please take your seat.
Thank you.
So, Dr. Sijja. Dr. Sijja, we have gone through your tab. If anything you want to tell which is not in the tab, then you can. Other than that, if you want to tell anything about yourself.
Sir, as you have already said, I am Sijja, sir. I'm not just doctor but also a singer, and recently I have started working in an NGO for providing telemedicine support during the time of COVID-19, and I've also started embracing physical activities, sir. Started running, going for cardio exercises as well as weight training.
Okay, Dr. Sijja, you are a singer in which language?
Sir, I sing in my college.
Okay, in which language? Obviously, it might be Telugu because you are from Andhra. Okay, good. So, our body temperature, how much?
Sir, it's 98.4 degree Fahrenheit.
So, if we don't know that how much it should be in the degree Celsius, then which is the formula we will use to convert this into degree Celsius?
Sir, it will be using 5 by 18.
What is that? Do you tell me again?
Sir, as far as I remember, it is converting degree centigrade to Fahrenheit. I think it's okay.
I can give you a little bit hint if you are not.
Yes, sir.
C by 5 equal to?
18 by.
No, C by 5 equal to F minus 32 by 9.
Yes, sir.
So then you can convert.
Thank you, sir.
Degree Celsius into Fahrenheit.
Yes.
Can there be any temperature which is equal both in degree Celsius and Fahrenheit? And if at all it could be, then what is that? Question is clear. Can there be any temperature, or is there any temperature which is equal both in degree Celsius and in degree Fahrenheit? If at all it is, then what is this? We can calculate with this only. If at all it is there, we can calculate with this formula only. So what is that? Which is equal both in degree Celsius as well as in degree Fahrenheit.
It is 8, sir.
Anyway, it is minus 40 degree. Equal both in degree Celsius as well as Fahrenheit. Okay. Ahimsa silk. Ahimsa. You understand the word Ahimsa?
Yes, sir.
Mahatma Gandhi wala Ahimsa.
Yes.
So Ahimsa silk, have you ever heard about this?
Okay, for generating silk, the cocoons are made to boil live. But the same silk, when they start extracting, by not killing the cocoons, or when the moth generally converts into, when the larva converts into moth in the process, waiting for the cocoon to be released.
Very good. So first we allow the larva to get out from the cocoon, and then we boil them. That's why Ahimsa silk. Very good. What do you mean by virtual autopsy? Virtual autopsy.
Yes, sir. Sir, that is using the radiological techniques, sir, which are available for us. Instead of directly going for autopsy of a patient, we use different technologies, medical technologies like radiology, CT scan, MRI and all, to identify the changes which have happened within the internal organs of the person to identify the cause of death.
So, what are the advantages of this virtual autopsy? Whatever you have said, that's right. But what are the advantages of this?
So, firstly, expertise. We can limit the expert personnel to reach to the point of location in times of pandemic. And if at all the patient is someone who has been infected with some deadly disease like COVID-19 itself, using virtual autopsy would be better, sir. And also, virtual autopsy gives us a chance that even the patient is in rural area or area where it is, where just there are techniques but no experts, the same thing can be, by using the technology, the expert opinion can be accessed.
Okay. Can you name any country or some country where this is being done, virtual autopsy?
Sir, I'm exactly unaware of which country it is doing, but I think any country which has such kind of medical technology.
Do we have this?
Sir, we are capable. We are capable of doing that, sir. provided the medical facilities in any institution or overseas?
We have started this in AIMS, and I think this was started in the month of March and April. But you can check.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Yes, sir.
So, what is the difference between Down syndrome and Klinefelter syndrome?
Yes, sir. So, Down syndrome is trisomy.
Trisomy of chromosome number
21, sir.
Okay.
And Klinefelter male is one who has a double, an extra X chromosome, XXY, 46, XXY would be the genetic formula of him. So this makes him more feminized in spite of having the Y chromosome. While Down syndrome is one where the child tends to have web neck, tends to have certain autoimmune disorders. And generally, they tend to be mentally retarded, but quite efficient in creative activities.
Okay, human genome sequencing. What is the? When was it started? When the work on human genome sequencing was started?
Sir,
approximate idea, not exactly.
Sir, I think it is in 1990s. The US has started.
Yeah, 20 years. Yeah, before 20 years. So now, is it complete now?
Yes, sir, they have completed it and they have taken the other step also, probably converting it into a barcode instead of just having the sequences. They have wanted to convert it as a barcode. The same institution have taken up the second step for the same.
Okay, India is going to for genome sequencing of COVID-19 coronavirus, its mutants, different variants, genome sequencing of that, and it is going to collaborate with other countries. Can you name which are those countries with which we are going to collaborate in this direction? Anyway, you don't know. No problem. So, there are some people who say about COVID diplomacy that COVID diplomacy turned out to be vaccine diplomacy. VEXING, you know vaccine?
Yes, sir.
Vaccine means?
Something which is not useful.
When not useful, annoying, like that. So, some people say that our vaccine diplomacy turned out to be vaccine diplomacy. What is your take on it?
Sir, I think the time when vaccine diplomacy has started, we were not having this wave. And secondly, sir, it is important for us to identify that it is a pandemic. India cannot isolate itself from the world nations in a globalized world.
Mm-hmm.
And thirdly, the vaccine technology itself requires raw materials, technology and patents, which is dispersed among the different nations also. So being a partner among the world, India has taken an initiative, sir, in order to make its moral values be depicted in the kind of initiatives it takes in the time of pandemic. So I do think it's a good step instead of a vaccine.
Okay, it's still COVID second wave is not over.
Yes, sir.
And there's possibility that we can have third wave also. So my first question, being a doctor, what do you think? Is there any possibility of third wave? And if at all it's there, then whether it would be of same intensity as second wave, or more than that, or less than that, and whether we are prepared to face that if at all it happens.
Sir, all these things, based on my limited scientific knowledge, I can just say is a relative thing, sir. For sure, when as far as a virus is present, there are chances of variants to emerge. And the vaccine technology present now, and the health sector infrastructure, whichever is present now, is a relative thing to face the variant which is going to emerge. So I could say that third wave is a possibility, and all the other things which we have made is just a buffer. We need to wait and watch how it is going to turn. So better we get vaccinated in order to increase our buffered capacity and face the ongoing sequence. Thank you, sir.
What is the literacy rate of Telangana?
Sir, as per NSSO, it was 73%, sir,
in 2019.
Yes, sir.
Why? Because I see an anomaly in terms of higher education, in terms of IT jobs.
Yes, sir.
Andhra's contribution or Telangana's contribution is very high.
Yes, sir.
But average literacy rate is very low. What do you think is there?
Yes, sir. As you said, there are quite skilled personnel in Telangana, but the thing is, they're located in Hyderabad only, which has been the hub of education. And secondly, sir, historically, the Nizams have ruled Telangana region and Andhra region. And so, Urdu as a medium has emerged, sir, where the normal people with the colloquial Telugu language couldn't get access to education. And the results are awaited to be seen after the state getting bifurcated. And there are also other issues, sir, at the local level, that governance and poor infrastructure are also some concerns which the Ministry of Education has also noticed in Telangana.
Role of Ayush medicine in treatment of COVID?
Sir, Ayush has been an adjunct to provide treatment to the COVID-19. It has not replaced the treatment itself. For example, yoga and Ayurvedic medicines like Chyawanprash, which we eat also, is to increase our immunity level, to make ourselves embraced, to face the risk of being exposed to COVID-19. And yes, sir, it has been something which is helpful, but not has replaced the treatment itself.
What is your take on allowing Ayush doctors to conduct surgery?
Sir, I think it's a welcome step. Firstly, because surgery as a skill requires a number of years to become a well-trained surgeon. And the Ayush doctors are already performing certain kind of surgeries, sir. So bringing in guidelines will in turn regularize the same thing which is happening. But saying the same.
Independent Ayush discipline will not be,
yes,
able,
sir,
to do. They have to do the combination of allopathy and Ayush.
Yes, right? Sir. Because of the same issue, I think these guidelines will bring in an ecosystem where the Ayush doctors can work with the allopathic doctors also, provided that there is a dynamic change in the guidelines. Like they even allowed cholecystectomy, which is a complex procedure, which a trained surgeon also cannot perform. So such kind of things have to change with time, and they be limited to certain simple procedures, so that it's important for any person to get quality healthcare, sir, be it any kind of medicine system. So if we are able to provide it, I think it's justified.
We have certain vaccine manufacturers who's willing to come to India if we allow them for an indemnity clause.
Yes, sir.
What do you think?
Sir, we have already provided a number of leeways in the form of custom tax, decreasing the custom tax, opening single windows, avoiding the bridge trials and all. Further, giving vaccine indemnity, though increases our vaccination rate, but at the same time, the liability shifts towards the common people, sir. Instead, we can create a buffer fund where the government donates as well as the private manufacturer donates, and then we can allow vaccine indemnity, sir.
Osmania Medical College, can you tell me about your college?
Yes, sir. Sir, it is one of the oldest medical college. It was started in 1875 by Mir Usman Ali Khan, the last Nizam 7. And its specialty is, sir, it has a separate hospital for each and every specialty, which none of the college in India has, and with almost 6,000 beds, sir. And it is one of the super specialty hospital which caters to the needs of not just Telangana but also Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka also.
Telugu classical music.
Yes, sir.
So since when have you been training?
Sir, it was not a continuous training, sir. I couldn't get the access to the teacher. But since my fourth class, I started singing.
How is it different from Carnatic and Hindustani music?
Sir, classical singing is Carnatic and Hindustani. And Carnatic and Hindustani differ in the kind of technique, sir. Where there is a mean technique in Hindustani, where the tones tend to glide over one another, while in Carnatic, they tend to oscillate between notes. And in Carnatic, it's mostly practiced in South India, and it is more rigid, sir, for improvisation.
So Telugu is now has branched out from Carnatic music, or it's independent?
Sir, in Carnatic music, the singers have adopted different languages, sir, Sanskrit, Telugu, like Tyagaraja Swami and Annamacharya. They were famous in taking Carnatic music with Telugu songs. So it is just a subpart of Carnatic music.
RT-PCR.
Yes, sir.
Can you explain to
layman like us?
Sir, the technology involved in it?
RT-PCR, you have to explain. We only hear in the news every day.
Yes.
But we don't know what is RT-PCR. Can you explain?
Yes, sir. Sir, the reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction. Can we simply say as we have to find out the odd one out, sir. Here the odd one out is the actual target protein among the sample which we are going to extract. So that odd one can be identified by other thing which can only identify this odd one. So basically increasing the number of the sample and then finding so that more and more photocopies of the same gene are produced. So that probability of identifying the gene increases, and then the target component which is directed against this odd one is made to identify, sir.
Incidentally, who discovered reverse transcriptase?
Sorry, sir, I'm
not sure. In Baltimore, 4-5 decades back.
Thank you, sir.
Awarded Nobel Prize for it.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay. You said the target protein will be identified in RT-PCR. Why it is called reverse transcriptase?
Yes, sir. Because COVID-19 is a RNA virus, sir. We first convert the RNA into DNA and then we tend to increase its number, sir. We tend to make their photocopy. So, for doing this, we need an enzyme called reverse transcriptase, which converts RNA to DNA.
Why it is called reverse transcriptase? Yes.
Sir, because transcription is it's a component of producing protein, sir, from RNA, DNA and then protein.
You can tell it now. What is transcription?
Sir, from DNA, making RNA, then protein.
So you had the answer. Now, reverse transcription.
You had the answer. Yes, earlier you told, no?
Yes, sir. I got little confused.
Okay. The cycle count, what is its significance?
Sir, it's inversely proportional to the severity of disease. The more number of times the cycle has to take this, that means the less.
What is the cycle? What happens in a cycle?
Sir, increasing the number of as far as my limited knowledge goes, sir, it is to increase the sample number or photocopies, so that probability of finding among it.
So if you can detect in 5 cycles, that means viral load is high, right?
Yes, sir.
Some monument has got the World Heritage status in Telangana, right?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Sir, it is Ramappa.
Ramappa. Yes. What is the significance of that?
Sir, first significance is Ramappa is named after the sculptor. And it is only one architecture where it is named after a sculptor also, sir. And the floating brick technology because of being made up of basalt. And also the sandbox technology in the times of 12th century AD, sir.
What is sandbox?
Sir, it is a technique which they use, which the Kakatiyas have used in order to buffer the seismicity so that the architecture can be protected there. The sand, lime and products are called karakaya and jaggery is used as a mixture and is applied, and then the foundation stones are laid, sir. It is believed that they tend to give a buffer to the architecture during the time of earthquake. And also, sir, what I have recently understood is they even made small tunnels within the walls as well as to the roof and the foundation, and they poured the iron, molten iron, so that the structure together stands again to face the issue of seismicity.
Okay. India at 74.
Yes, sir.
What role your reflections on India at 74?
Sir, I think we have balanced well. Saying the same, we have still many to go. So firstly, the Olympic, I would like to talk about the sports, sir. We winning the gold medal and also winning bronze in hockey, which we were awaiting since years. So, and secondly, sir, we progressing towards trying to decrease the poverty. We have almost made almost 25 crore population, we could lift out of poverty, sir, in the past 20 years. And the trend of LPG reforms which we brought is quite successful also. Now we are a globalized nation in many sectors. And in terms of medical infrastructure, sir, and we have emerged as a pharma hub, providing vaccines not just for our nation, but also to the world. And also regarding IT services. But saying the same, there are certain issues also. Like women's safety is still an issue in India. And the paradox of having food in surplus, but having the issue of hunger and malnourishment in children is still a problem. We having skillful personnel, but still facing the issue of poor literacy is also something which we are facing.
Do you think governments have failed in addressing these challenges you face?
Sir, instead of saying failing...
75 years.
Yes. Yes, sir.
And we are not able to change the situation. Do we not be ashamed of this?
Sir, I don't think so, sir. Because a person tends to understand the issues itself. For example, me, sir. It is almost 25 years, I couldn't identify the complexities in societies. I am just deciphering it. The same thing goes with a nation also. It took time to understand it and decipher it. So...
There is also an Indian mRNA vaccine.
Yes, sir.
Which is coming up.
Yes.
Anything into the vaccine? Or being manufactured?
Sir, it is biologically limited. It is self-amplifying mRNA vaccine, sir.
Biology. Genova.
Yes, sir. Genova is also an mRNA. Having the few symptoms of COVID-19, even after getting completely treated or RT-PCR report getting negative.
Even after okay. And what are the symptoms or the problems with the facial
patients? Sir, what I have from the calls which I have received, they were saying that cough was even prevalent after 2 months of getting RT-PCR negative. There was still an issue of improper smell being detected. And yes, sir, these were few things which I could identify in the patient.
What would have done to prevent the second wave?
Sir, I don't think we could have done anything to prevent the second wave. Because firstly, it was because of a variant, sir, which has emerged. And that could have been because the first wave was present. This goes on, sir, from the time of emergence. Secondly, we could have increased the intensity for sure, sir, by identifying that there is a risk of a variant to emerge. Thirdly, the vaccination rate. We could have been the same in the same way vigorous in between first and second wave.
Preparations with related to oxygen, for example, I think Maharashtra was already ahead 1.5 months. We had some time to figure out the variant and all this.
So it was said that the issue of oxygen has emerged because of the variant making more and more patients into moderate and severe category, and this was something because of which was due to the variant, sir. And Maharashtra was the place which was mostly affected, so probably the emergency would have made the people to identify that there could be risk of oxygen also, and also moderate to severe patients, which made them to buffer the capacity.
There was also talks of Andhra variant also.
Yes, sir, it was in news, but the Andhra variant was ruled out by the WHO. Okay. The name.
So it's not a variant of concern.
Sir, WHO has not said anything regarding.
What are the new vaccines which are going to come in the coming few months?
Yes, sir. So one is Zydus Cadila, the plasmid DNA vaccine, and the biologically limited one, sir, and the Genova mRNA vaccine. And we started even giving emergency use authorization for Moderna, and Pfizer is also in pipeline, sir.
Do you think India will do very badly in the non-communicable diseases sector? Because I think the government is still not paying much attention.
Sir, I won't completely say that we would not do, but saying the same, we have to do a lot, sir. Because firstly, the trend of NCDs have been on a higher side. Secondly, in regards to what the government has done, sir, or doing, health and wellness centers, sir. They imbibe mental health, mental counseling and psychological counseling and yoga aspect. That are those subjects which are required to decrease the incidence of non-communicable disease. And also we started imbibing more and more into ourselves the fitness culture, sir. Be it Fit India, Eat Right Movement and all. So indirectly we are actually trying to curb the cause of NCDs itself.
Why is Kerala witnessing so many cases? I think there was a visit by the central team also.
Yes, sir.
And they highlighted certain reasons. Can you tell me about it?
Sir, few reasons could be, firstly, it having 4 international airports, sir. So the visitor arrival is also on a higher end. And secondly, sir, the NRIs. Kerala...
NRIs, sir.
So they tend to bring the variants across the world into Kerala also. And thirdly, identifying that the case rate is also dependent on they being notified, sir. Having a healthcare system which is robust has also a disadvantage or advantage that the case rate to be notified
in the financial year 21-22, what is the percentage of GDP spending on health?
21-22, it is 1.8% GDP, sir. And this year it is almost 2,23,000 crore, I think so, sir.
Okay. Last question. Why are we witnessing slowdown in the country for the last 3-4 years?
So it is because of the reasons which were prevalent earlier. The issue of poor liquidity because of NPA crisis and double balance sheet syndrome and all. And secondly, failure of major banks and NBFCs also. And thirdly, could have been because of few steps which we have started actually in a good intention, but they didn't turn out to be in good way. For example, GST and also the demonetization which we had to take. So, these could be few reasons that the economic slowdown could have.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.